I'll show you how easy it is to automate browser activity with Kameleo on websites with advanced protection. We can easily start different browsers with different IP locations and browser fingerprints, and then use the Selenium framework to browse automatically. Here I purchase my favorite sneakers. The websites I visit see my browsers as they are working from different computers from different locations. First, let me show you the limitations of the regular Selenium framework. Then I'll introduce Kameleo by using its graphical user interface. After that, we'll see how simple it is to write code for Kameleo. Last but not least, I'll show that Kameleo is not only compatible with Selenium, but also provides a Puppeteer interface for browser automation. For the first demo, I create a Python project using PyCharm IDE, developer environment. I just import the Selenium package and start a browser with a local instance of Chrome. Then I make the browser open a bot detection website. The problem is that the website sees that I'm using Selenium WebDriver. Websites with advanced security won't let me browse automatically with a browser started by Selenium. Let's see how Kameleo provides a solution to this issue. Kameleo is a whole browsing platform that enables you to create virtual browser profiles. After logging into the graphical user interface, we can filter from hundreds of thousands of real-life configurations called base profiles. You can see profiles with different languages, browsers, and OS versions. I select a profile with Chrome browser and use English language. I can configure the browser fingerprint, for example, Canvas, WebGL, time zone, geolocation. Kameleo provides good default values to start with, so I leave these as is and only set up a proxy. I'm going to use Bright Data as a proxy provider. I like their service because it's highly configurable for anyone's needs. They have cheaper data center proxies and excellent residential proxies. I prefer to use ISP proxies because they are never blacklisted, and I can set them up to use the same IP during the whole browsing session per each browser started by Kameleo. Let's use a proxy from the United Kingdom. I can simply copy and paste the connection details to my Kameleo profiles edit page. See that the country code is provided in the username? And here I can set up a sticky IP with any random session ID. I can test the connection, and everything seems fine, so I start the browser. As you can see, my IP changed, and the browser's fingerprint as well. The website sees I'm browsing the internet on a Windows 8.1 device. And the best thing is that the presence of Selenium framework is completely hidden despite the browser can be fully automated with Kameleo's stealth web driver. So I'm going to show you how. This next section is about how to automate Kameleo and connect to the browsers using Selenium stealth web driver. First of all, you need to automate the actions of Kameleo I previously showed. For example, creating profiles and starting browsers. To make this easier, a very handy Python package is available. This package is wrapping the local REST API of Kameleo. These are HTTP endpoints that can be called from your code to automate the work with your browser profiles. This local API is available from any programming language, but we also created an NPM package for Node.js developers and a NuGet package for .NET developers. See our examples on GitHub to see all the features. For example, here it shows how to start a profile with a proxy with just a few lines of Python code. Now I start a new Python project in PyCharm. I use pip install to get the Kameleo.local API client from PyPI. When I use automation features of Kameleo, I start the Kameleo command line interface instead of the graphical interface. Kameleo.cli.exe is located in the program folder. As you can see, the CLI is ready to receive my commands through the local API I talked about earlier. You can see the API documentation now on localhost at port 5050. Here I can execute any command. For example, I try to list the profiles currently loaded into the Kameleo application. The result is an empty array, as there are no profiles created yet. So in my Python code, I set up Kameleo local API client instance that's going to communicate with Kameleo CLI on the given port. I just import this client from the PyPI package. Then I can make my first request using the methods of the client. As you can see, the code completion feature will help you to find the method you need. First, I filter the base profiles. I'll search for Chrome profiles with American English language. Let's run the code. As you can see, the CLI has received the request, and I returned a list of matching base profiles for my filter criteria. This is very familiar when I have filtered the base profiles on the graphical user interface. Now I'm going to create a browser profile that browser fingerprint configuration is derived from, one of these base profiles. I use this builder to set up my request properly. I prefer the recommended defaults, but I also set up an HTTP proxy. I can simply enter the proxy connection details for the profile. I'll copy the data from Bright Data. I want to use IP addresses from the United States. This is set up by adding the country code to the username field. To ensure that I have the same IP address during the whole browsing session, I provide a random session ID. You can pass any random value here or generate it in your code. See the link for Bright Data's documentation of sticky IPs in the video description. Now, as the request is ready, we can send it to the CLI with the client instance. Let's see it in action. The browser profile has been created. This is similar to when we have configured the profile's browser fingerprint on the GUI. Now we are ready to start the browser with the configured browser fingerprint. You can see the requests on the CLI's standard output. Searching base profiles, then creating the profile, and then starting the browser. We can see that the IP has been changed for the browser, and all parts of the fingerprint are consistent. For example, the time zone is spoofed. As I close the browser, the CLI gets notified about this event. Next thing is connecting to the browser with Selenium. For this, I install the official Selenium Python package. The connection can be made through Kameleo by providing the profile's ID as a capability to the remote web driver. The command executor must be set to Kameleo's port, so no session ID needs to be provided manually. These codes can be easily copied from the package's README file. Now I can use regular Selenium commands to control the browser, which is fully protected by Kameleo's browser fingerprint spoofing technology. the provided website opens up, and I can see my favorite sneakers. Despite I use Selenium, websites cannot see that I'm using Chrome Driver or Gecko Driver at all. Now I finished the task with some regular Selenium commands, so the correct size of shoes will be automatically placed into my cart. If you're not familiar with Selenium, you can learn it easily from the web. You can find thousands of example codes for almost every task you want to perform. But this time you won't be blocked on more advanced sites because of the protection of Kameleo. What I do here is use selectors to interact with the dropdowns and buttons on the website. Let's see it in action. Sorry for the glitch. Here I made a typo. Now I'm running the code again. The profile is starting and my Selenium code performs everything automatically. Sneaker site opens. My code selects the desired size and adds it to the basket. I can close browsers from my code as well. You can see that there are plenty of other features of Kameleo. You can list your cookies so you can transfer them to some other systems and reuse them there. But the best part is that you can save a Kameleo profile with all of its data to a profile file. So you can load back the fingerprint configuration with the browsing data, such as cookies. This way you can continue your work at any time and you'll be logged into the sites you are already logged into. Here comes another powerful feature of Kameleo. I can simply change the browser and its language by simply changing three parts of the code. I change Chrome to Firefox and then select language to Turkish. I also update the proxy configuration to get a Turkish IP. That was all. Now Firefox starts. And websites think that I'm browsing from Turkey. Kameleo is also compatible with Puppeteer, which is another browser automation technology that became popular lately. To show you how Kameleo works with Puppeteer, I'm going to use Node.js. Let's create a new project. An NPM package of the Kameleo local API client is available. I can install it using the NPM install command. I create a new JavaScript file and copy-paste the example code from the package's README file. This is basically the same as we did in the Python project. It creates a profile and starts the browser, but it uses Node.js code this time. Now I install and import the official Puppeteer package as well. The connection to the browser is similar to the way I use for Selenium. I can simply connect to the browser through Kameleo using a WebSocket connection. Then I can control the browser with any Puppeteer command and enjoy the full protection of Kameleo. Thank you. let me show you just a quick sneak peek of what our dev team is currently working on. In the upcoming versions, Kameleo will support the automation of mobile profiles by emulating the browser on a desktop PC. Automation on Android devices is also in progress, but it is currently in a very early stage, so stay tuned for further updates in our upcoming videos. You can find more information by clicking the links in our video description.